2018, astronomers used the Gaia Space Telescope to map our Milky Way galaxy. They tracked the movements of a billion stars, and they found that some behave very strangely.
When astronomers were mapping stars in our galaxy, they found a whole bunch that were on similar but very strange orbits.
Most stars of the Milky Way are orbiting in a sort of regular pattern, but these stars at the center, they're in these highly elongated orbits.
Coming in from very far, swinging around the center of our galaxy and then going back out again. It's a little bit like a comet does.
You get a shape that looks a bit like a sausage.
This doesn't sound very sciencey, but this sausage is really what the stars look like if you look at the shapes of their orbits in a certain configuration.
What sent so many stars on such a strange path? It must have been a huge event.
We think these stars are the result of a past cosmic collision.
They are casualties from an enormous battle between the Milky Way and a foreign galactic army.
They don't move like stars in the Milky Way because they're not from the Milky Way. These stars are actually alien stars. They're invaders from outer space.
The attackers left their mark on the Milky Way. We find similar battle scars on galaxies across the universe.
Our models of galaxy formation are still pretty uncertain. We still don't really understand how galaxies got to where they are, how we go from the Big Bang to the Milky Way.
Wars between galaxies have profound consequences for the winners, the losers, and for us.
What we're learning is that these galactic battles have had a huge impact on what the universe looks like today.
Our understanding of galaxies has changed entirely in the last few decades. We understand now that every big galaxy like the Milky Way started from many smaller things colliding, changing each other as they went.
Nearly 10 billion years ago, the sausage stars were part of a foreign galaxy. It was on a collision course with our home, the Milky Way. We call this invading army the Sausage Galaxy, or Gaia Enceladus.
The galaxy that we fought probably had about 50 billion stars. So we're talking about something that is a significant fraction of the size of the Milky Way.
Gaia Enceladus was a tough opponent. But the Milky Way was 20 times its mass. That makes a huge difference.
When galaxies interact with each other, size definitely matters. The bigger galaxies are going to dominate over the smaller ones, ripping them apart and essentially consuming them.
Galaxy interactions are all about bullies. The bigger you are, the badder you are.
When two galaxies collide, it's like two massive armies marching towards each other. These galaxies aren't fighting with knives or spears or guns or even nuclear bombs. They're fighting with something much more powerful, gravity itself.
Each galaxy contains billions of stars and planets, and a supermassive black hole, millions of times the mass of the sun. That's a lot of gravitational firepower.
One galaxy can stretch another galaxy along a certain direction.
As Gaia Enceladus advanced towards us, our galaxy's superior gravity grabbed hold of the smaller galaxy.
As it approached, the gravity from the Milky Way would have stretched it out.
Gaia Enceladus was distorted, but not defeated. The battle was just beginning.
It would have passed through our galaxy, maybe orbiting a couple of times, before being torn apart by our gravity.
The Milky Way's gravitational power ripped Gaia Enceladus apart and captured billions of its stars.
Eventually, most of those stars would have then settled down into the disk of the Milky Way and become a part of it.
Little galaxy try to take on the Milky Way, you're gonna get what's coming to you.
Despite winning the battle, the Milky Way suffered serious damage.
The collision with the Sausage Galaxy left a scar on the Milky Way. And when we look near the center of our galaxy, we see a bulge that's left over from that collision.
The Milky Way isn't the only galaxy scarred by war. Across the universe, rival armies made up of billions of stars slug it out, leaving behind distorted and damaged casualties of war.
There are galaxies that look like they might have collided with one another and blown holes through each other.
These battle scars give us important clues about one of the biggest mysteries in astronomy: how galaxies develop and grow. But there's a problem. We can't watch these battles in real time.
The scale of galaxies is huge. They're hundreds of thousands of light years across. It's going to take them millions or billions of years to come together.
So it's like looking at one frame from a really energetic fight scene in a movie.
By piecing these snapshots together, astronomers can build up a detailed picture of past conflicts and discover how these battles transformed galaxies over billions of years.
We have pictures of isolated galaxies, we have pictures of interacting galaxies, and we have pictures of aftermath galaxies.
And that's helped us discover something alarming. The Milky Way faces yet another attack from an enemy armed with an enormous secret weapon. Will our solar system survive the onslaught? Across the universe, galaxies are at war. Their main weapon? Gravity. It tears the combatants into weird and wonderful shapes. Our galaxy didn't escape the mayhem. It's peppered with battle scars.
The overall shape of the Milky Way is a flat disk of stars and gas. Except recently, we have found out that at the edges, it's actually warped a little bit, like the brim of a fedora. The stars actually dip down below the plane on one side and dip above it on the other.
We think the attacker was one of our satellites, a galaxy that orbits the Milky Way like the moon orbits the Earth. It's called the Sagittarius Dwarf Galaxy.
From looking at how the stars move in the Milky Way, we suspect that the Sagittarius Dwarf Galaxy has actually crashed through the Milky Way a few times on its course of its orbit around the galaxy.
It came in about 6 billion years ago, hit the disk hard about 2 billion years ago, and crashed again about a billion years ago.
And our gravity has pulled it out into a gigantic looping stream of stars that is moving in and out of our Milky Way.
The war is not over. The insurgent galaxy will return.
When galaxies interact, often they're caught in this huge cosmic dance where they revolve around each other a few times, or they even crash through each other and then come back around. The Sagittarius Dwarf Galaxy looks like it's crashing in with ever-increasing frequency.
A new skirmish could take place in the next 100 million years. So, should we be worried about these attacks?
Because the Sagittarius Dwarf Galaxy is so small compared to the Milky Way, it will do some damage at the beginning, but because we're so massive, we can absorb the impact. I mean, this galaxy, it's looking for a fight, but it's also 10,000 times smaller than us, so this is gonna be no sweat at all.
So far, the Milky Way has been victorious. But the danger isn't over. We are surrounded by enemies.
Our local neighborhood of galaxies has 3 major galaxies, but up to 50 smaller ones. All these galaxies are potential troublemakers. Each one of these could be armies that rise up against us.